Yesterday. One more minute of warming up, then we'll come down to our mats and do a little dynamic warm up. Downward dog, pedaling the feet out. And then kick your left leg back, pull the knee forward, flattening out into plank as that knee comes forward towards your chest. 5 times on each side. Switch when you've gotten to 5. And then when you've done 5 kickbacks on both sides, drop down onto your hands and knees. We're doing cat-cow. Make sure those hands are underneath your shoulders. Knees about hip-width apart. Start with a nice flat back. Pull your, or tuck your chin to your chest around the back. And then arch the back, head out. We're doing this 5 times. Nice and controlled. Getting some movement through the spine. Good.
Excellent.
Okay, when you've gotten to five on both sides, I want you to take your hand, place it on your neck, start, and you're still in that tabletop position. Start with your elbow pointing down. Rotate up gently, five times. Switch when you've got two, five on each side. Okay, after you've gotten five on both sides, I want you to come up onto one knee. And we're pulsing forward. You can either have your hands on your hips. You want to get a little bit deeper into that stretch. Arms overhead. Looking up towards the ceiling. Keeping that foot connected to the ground. Sorry, I'm just texting the person who could help with this. The hand opposite that leg you need, place it on the ground, rotate up, looking up towards the ceiling. And then rotate around. Hand, it's on the inside of that lunging leg. We're still on the same side. If it helps, you can be on your fist, or you can grab one of your weights if you need a little more height for that hand. Good. And then let's come back up. Pulsing forward. So for those of you who take some of the classes downstairs, do they have the same stair over shoes? Have you noticed? Just up here. Maybe. Oops. They do? Okay.
Other instructors in this room have the same problem.
They do? Okay.
It's not a you thing.
I was trying to think the stereo has something against me. Good. And let's switch legs. So either hands on the hips or overhead. Hand on the ground, rotate up. I feel like most of the issue started when we connected the Bluetooth. Well, I know that's not the issue. Good, rotate around. Both arms up or hands on the hips, finishing this out. And then sweep those arms back, place them on the ground, feet back behind you. We're back in downward dog, pulling the feet out, and then when you're ready, start to walk those hands in. Come up nice and slow, some shoulder circles to the back, opening up the chest. some Y, T's, and W's. This is your starting point. Then we're coming into a Y, back to the middle, T, back to the middle, W. Pull those shoulder blades down the back. Let's go again. Y, T, W. Y, T, W. Two more times through. Y, T, W. One more time. Y, T, W. And then swing those arms front to back. Give yourself a hug, and then we're rotating from the hips. Okay, let's talk about what we have in store today. Okay, so we've got three circuits with four exercises in them each. We're gonna go through it three times, do our typical intervals of 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. We're going to start with Renegade Row. You can do this a couple different ways. Can do it. This is the standard way. So you start in high plank, hands on your weights, wide stance with the feet, and you're rowing, pulling that elbow up. Try not to rotate the body. So squeezing those glutes, core is braced. You can modify and drop down onto your knees, rowing. You can get rid of the weights. Do it in high plank, same thing. Or on your knees, or slight variation of exercise, you could do a bird dog row. So, extending one leg out, bracing the core, rowing with one arm. If you're doing that, we'll break. I'll let you know when you're 20 seconds in and you can switch sides. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, push-ups. Good old-fashioned push-ups, nothing wrong with them. Standard, down, press it up, head, neck, and shoulders, torso all in line. Core is braced, it's basically a plank where you're lowering yourself and raising yourself up. You can do it on your knees. You can do it on your bench. You can do it on the wall. You can do it on the bench back there, which is a little higher than your bench that you have here. So, a couple different ways. If push-ups really bother your wrists, do a chest press with your weight. Okay, your choice. Okay, don't hate me. Weighted burpees. So, holding those weights, squat down, jump the feet out, push up, jump the feet in, curl, press it up. If you want to do burpees without any weights, you can. Get light weights for your burpees.
If you
want to leave out the push-up, then you know what, keep moving. But another modification, you can use your bench so you don't have to go down as far. Do your push-up there. Lock the feet in, curl, press it up. Okay, and then the dice of fun, all different exercises. This says number of reps, we're just gonna do it whatever we get for 40 seconds. And we'll pass around the clock, so. Start over here. Okay, are you ready? I get my stopwatch ready to go. Okay. Renegade Row or Bird Dog Row? Is anybody doing Bird Dog Row? Okay. I will be aware of time and let you know when we're at 20 seconds. Okay. Let's get this party started. Okay. Clock is started. So if you're doing Bird Dog, you'll drop down.
I wasn't doing Bird Dog.
Oh, get your second leg.
So yeah, I was just thinking are we doing the same arm or?
You're alternating, if you're doing Renegade Row, you're alternating arms. There you go, yeah. Push feet down on the ground, hips level. There you go, good. That's 20 seconds, which side? We get to do this. Okay, here we go. In 3, 2, and 1. Let's do it. Keep those elbows in. Head, neck, and shoulders in line. Don't let that head lead the way. Thank you. up. Feet in. Curl. Press it up. Bring it down the way they came. And again. We are more than halfway through. Seconds. Come on, finish this off. 3, 2, 1. Finish wherever you're at in that movement. Good job. Okay. Left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Stop.
Okay. We need carpe diems in about 11 seconds. Okay.
Again.
Burpee!
Oh, again.
No.
done. Okay. Let's talk about circuit number two. Okay. You are going to grab your medium weight. First exercise is a step up, hammer curl, to overhead press. Bring it down, step back. If you want to add a step up to the knee drive, add a little extra balance. You can do that too, but make sure your balance is in a good place. You can do that, or you can just step up to top your hammer curl to overhead press. That's number one. Number two, we're gonna do squats. Grab your heavier weights. Just hold them at your chest. Goblet squat, so nice wide stance. We're gonna go down nice and slow. Brass it up. Okay? Then clean and press. Moderate to heavy weight for this. You're gonna be alternating arms. Squatting down. Grab that weight. Pull it up to the shoulder. Press it up. Bring it back down the way you came. Grab it with the other hand down the bottom. If your range of motion prevents you or forces you to kind of roll forward to grab that weight like this, I'd rather see you put it up a little bit so you can keep that torso up as you grab the weight. So you can use your bench. That bench back there is a little bit higher too to make it worth the view where you're at. Clean and press, and then, you know the drill, roll the dice. If we get burpees again, I will make you.
Okay. You're not bad.
Okay, here we go. Hammer curl to overhead press while you're stepping up. You guys ready? Let's do this. Clock is started. And that's 40. Okay, we're doing some squats, goblet squats. Everyone good? We're going in 7 seconds. Weights into position, nice wide stance. Connect your feet to the ground. Think of your feet as a tripod. Big toe, little toe, heel. Pressing through that entire foot. Nice and slow going down. Press the ground away as you stand up. Nice. We have about 5 more seconds of this. And that is 40 seconds right there. Okay. We have clean and press. We're on 5 seconds. Remember, alternating arms. Either weight on the ground or weight on your bench. And let's go. Squat. As you stand up, pull it up, press it up, bring it down, come back down. Everyone good? We're good. And use that momentum as you stand up. Bring that weight overhead. that quick feet. Or if you want to kind of do three tuck jumps and then take a break and march, that's fine. Make it work for you. We're going in 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Again, modification if you need to. Land on those feet if you can. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Okay. Back to the top, guys. And curl all of that stuff up. I love when the music coordinates with what we have to do.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Hammer curl, overhead press. Ready to step up. Seconds. Now that's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Clean and press. Towards the spine, make sure the back is not arching off the wall. Good
Check in on that back. I know I tend to arch off the wall, so I have to kind of continually check in on myself. Isn't it funny when you stop moving, that's when the sweat like starts pouring down. We have 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice work. Okay, we got one more time through.
I think the stereo has to get warmed up. It's like okay now.
Just takes us a little while to find our groove.
So when I start feeling like
yep. Okay, here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. Seven,
We are going to do, start out with some tricep kickbacks with a side lunge. So this is your starting position. Arms bent 90 degrees. Step out in that side lunge, hinging at the hips, pressing back. Pull up to 90 degrees, alternating legs. So stepping slightly forward with that lunging leg, getting into that hinge. Back is nice and flat as you press back in those tricep kickbacks. Then we're going to do deadlifts. So grab those heavier weights. Shoulders down and back. Lock those shoulder blades down. Using those lats to pull the shoulder blades down. Weights are out in front. Hinging forward, skimming the weights along your shins. Pressing the ground away, keeping that back nice and flat. That's number one. Then you're going to get rid of one of your weights. Holding it by the top, same thing. Shoulder blades down and back, swinging, coming up to chest height, keeping that core nice and tight, knees are soft, using that momentum as you come down to bring it up, and then rolling the dice. 12 minutes of fun, and we're done. Okay, we have our tricep kickback. Grab your lighter weights for these. Ready. Let's go. Perfect. Bring it back right to here. Try to keep those elbows tight against your torso. Press back. Really isolating those triceps. About 13 seconds. And it's just a slight step forward in that side lunge. Three, two. So, and one other thing, keep those feet parallel to each other.
Yep.
As you step side to side. Okay, we're going into deadlifts. Grab your heavier weights. Before we start, shoulder blades down and back, core is tight, even hip width a little bit wider, hinge forward, stand up. One thing to think about, keep head, neck, and shoulders in line. So when you stand up, you're looking out, that head follows your torso down. So when you're down at the bottom of the deadlift, you're looking down at the ground. Three, two, one. Okay, we have our dumbbell swing. So grab that weight from the top. Shoulder blades down and back. You guys ready? Here we go. Hinge forward, swing it, shoulder height. Please sing if the feeling overcomes you. Good, guys. Keeping that core tight. Back is nice and flat. Three, two, one.
Nice job.
Okay, tricep kickbacks with our side lunge. Oh, roll the dice. Yeah. Lower yourself down, press it up. Does anybody have problems with this with too much pressure on your wrist?
Are you on your heels
high heels. Yeah. You can have your legs straight too. Let's go. This is our warm up for tricep dips. Yep, press it out. Good. Squeeze at the top. Yeah, if it bothers your wrist, overhead tricep extensions. Shoulder blade flat. Three, two, one. Okay, we got our dumbbell swing. Okay, let's get into position. Before you start, shoulder blades down and back. Core is engaged. Here we go. Swing. Shoulder height.
I have an experiment.
Keep going, guys. Rotating.
Side lunge and just really focus on the triceps, kicking it back. Shoulder blades down and back. Core engage. And let's go. Hinge forward.
Cross the ground away just enough.
Halfway through.
Check on those lats. Where are your shoulders? Shoulder blades.
Belly button towards the spine, raise the core. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, dumbbell swing in 10 seconds.
Okay, let's get into position. Shoulder blades down and back.
Ready? Let's go. Halfway, come on. Feel your strength and power. Let's go. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay.
Rest of us are third.
Okay, hands are underneath your shoulders. Knees hip width apart. Tuck the chin. Round the back. Arch the back. Head on. Sit back onto your heels. We're in child's pose. Stretch those arms out. Relax the head. Let yourself fall deep into the stretch with every breath. Let the stretch come to you. And then when you're ready, I want you to walk your hands over to the left side. This targets the lats. And then the right side. Back to the middle, and we're going to get into pigeon pose. So bringing the left leg under the body, right leg back, or if you want to roll onto your back, you can do a figure four stretch. Your choice, pigeon pose or figure four. Sides. And then let's come out of pigeon pose, place the hands on the ground, press up, pedal the feet out, and then walk the hands in, slowly come up, shoulder circles to the back, opening up the chest, shoulder circles forward, and when you're ready, swing the arms front to back. Give yourself a hug, and we're rotating from the hips, keeping that back nice and flat. Okay, awesome guys, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm gonna go grab another spray bottle, but if you can spray down one of the towels and then wipe your equipment.
Before you do it, that'd be great. I'll be right back.
Yeah, it's good to be here.
Thank you.
voice. Thank you.
Sorry, brain fart.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.